Hello, hi everybody. I am Thekla Petridou, a psychologist, a YouTuber, and an author. And today it's Friday, the 27th of September 2020, and this is our weekly video in English. Our subject today, our topic, is how to deal with anxiety in these times of pandemic. Our lives have changed so significantly in the last months. Since around the spring of 2020, the new coronavirus and the pandemic it caused has made us wonder about our health, our safety, and all of us, even people that never experienced any significant anxiety before, have to deal with anxiety related to their health and their safety. As a psychologist, I should point out that people with diagnoses that had to do with anxiety, such as generalized anxiety disorder or some specific anxiety disorder, at these times can be especially vulnerable or susceptible for their anxiety levels to rise up. Nevertheless, anybody in this community are affected by the situation. It's very important, first of all, to understand our anxiety and how natural our anxiety is. It is so very natural to worry that something might go wrong in our lives, that we might get sick, that our lives might be put in danger, our lives and the lives of our loved ones. In these times that are something that we have never experienced before. For example, I am 47 years old, and it's the first time that I experienced a pandemic. Of course, if you go back in history, you can see that many times during human history, the globe has faced pandemics. But in our times, it's something that is we are not so ready to accept. Of course, in some areas, like in Africa and other third world countries, there were local epidemics, but now we have to deal with a pandemic, which means it's a global danger around the globe, around the world, for people to get sick from the new coronavirus. This creates a lot of uncertainty. We are not sure what will happen next. For example, when this year started in 2020, in January, most of us could not predict in any way how this year would come out. Nobody could predict that the pandemic would emerge, that we have to subject ourselves to lockdown, that we would have to use masks or use disinfectants as a daily routine. If somebody told me last year that, you know, next September you're gonna wear a mask every time you get out of the house, a disposable mask like the ones you see in films that Asian people use, I wouldn't believe. I would say, no, there is no such case. These things do not happen in Cyprus, they do not happen in Greece, they don't happen in Europe, they don't happen in the US, it happens in some areas of Asia. We have very good medication, medicine has advanced a lot, modern medicine has advanced, and there is no way that we can be in that situation that we are informed that there is a danger for our health and safety. This uncertainty, the thing that we could have not predicted in any way, I mean, a simple person, because I watch now some epidemiologists talking, giving interviews or writing books that they were trying to predict that, or they gave some cautions to health authorities that there is a danger of a new pandemic. But as plain people, we didn't know that. So we didn't worry about it. Now that we know that we have a pandemic, of course we worry about it. And what makes us worry most is the uncertainty. We cannot plan our future. We don't know what will happen in a week. We don't know what will happen in a month. We don't know what will happen in a year. The truth is that we never know what will happen next. But people as human beings, we have this homeostasis pattern in our bodies and in our brains and in our psyche, that we make ourselves feel sure about the future. I'm sure that if I try my best, I will be in a good position. So now, pandemic makes it difficult for us to feel this false sense of certainty, because everybody who feels sure about what will happen in the future is not really sure. He believes he's sure, she believes she's sure. And by believing that she's sure, she feels better. It's a defense mechanism to predict the future or try to manipulate the future. Nobody can actually manipulate the future, but if we really believe that we can manipulate it, we feel better because we have the sense of control. Sense of control over our lives takes anxiety away. Loss of control over our lives brings anxiety near. So it is essential for us to understand that it is only natural to feel anxiety about our health and our future, because it's a very new situation, the situation of a pandemic. We haven't been educated in order to face such a situation. We never expected this to happen as daily people. So this uncertainty causes anxiety. How do we deal with anxiety? The most important source of uncertainty is watching 24/7 the news, watching every news bulletin that comes out, watching every new press release, every new piece of news that comes into your attention. Watch it and listen to everything and be flooded with information about the pandemic situation that are not so necessary for everybody to have. And of course, not all the sources are reliable. And nowadays, the use of internet has given a lot of space to many untrustworthy sources to circulate rumors or fake news or conspiracy theories. So my opinion, my advice, is to avoid the news. Not avoid the news altogether, but select a couple of trustworthy sources for your information, stick to those trustworthy sources, and check on them, not every 5 minutes, not every hour, not every 30 minutes, once a day. I mean, you can find one time in your day, maybe that would be in the morning or in the afternoon, for example, 10 o'clock in the morning, I will check the World Health Organization portal, or I will check the CDC portal, one of these trustworthy sources, and then I will not watch news that dramatize the situation and they feed on our anxiety in order to get more views and in order to get from revenue from taxes. This is how news work. This is the industry of news. Through television, through the internet. Globally, if you watch any news channel in any language, in any country, you will see that there is a lot of drama. In the news, a lot of negative things are emphasized and a lot of positive things are failed to be mentioned. So I'm not saying to be to totally avoid the news, but you can stick to trustworthy sources and check them once a day. If you feel overwhelmed, even by checking once a day the data, you could step away and trust someone who is reliable to share an important update. For example, I do this. The truth is that I don't have too much time anyway to check the news, but I have a friend who's an academic and he works on the health field, and I told him every time, if there is any important update for me to know about the coronavirus pandemic, please share with me. So once a week or once every 10 days, he sends an article to me, or he sends a link, or he sends a video message to me, or he sends a text, and he informs me. My friend is Dr. John Mamelegis, He's an American of Greek origin who works for the World Health Organization. And currently, he's in Greece helping with the dealing with the coronavirus pandemic. So I trust Yannis to share with me important updates. He usually sends me some links to read about some studies that have positive and reassuring results. He shares some funny things, but I trust that he is the source of my information, for myself, I mean. I also follow him on Twitter, I follow him on Facebook, and I read his posts, because I know that he's a scientist, I know that he's not exaggerating things, I know that he's serious, I trust his studies, he's a doctor he has a PhD and a post-PhD title, and he has studied in very prestigious universities, and he's a world-renowned researcher, so I trust the information he gives me. So you could do that also, find someone in your life, someone that you know in person, or someone that you can follow on social media, who is a trustworthy person, who is a scientific origin person, who is not into spreading rumors or fake news or anything, and base your information on reliable people. So it's a no-no to watch the news all the time. It's a no-no to wake up in the morning and the first thing you do is check your phone to see how many new people were diagnosed with coronavirus in my area, how many people died, how many people did this, how many people did that. I think it's a very good idea not to. Because by watching the news all the time, we feed our anxiety with more and more negative information. So, instead of watching the news and focusing on uncertainty and things we can't control, it's a good idea to focus on the things we can control. What can we control during the pandemic? We can control to wash our hands thoroughly for 20 seconds each time. We can focus on not touching our face, our nose, our mouth, and our eyes with our hands. This is very important. This is not my advice. It's the advice of the World Health Organization and all trustworthy health agencies. We practice social distancing and we take care of ourselves by taking a lot of sleep. Sleeping is important for our immune system to be in a good condition, and also sleeping and healthy sleeping helps us deal with anxiety better. And it's a very good idea to stick on a healthy diet. Lots of vegetables, lots of fruit, a healthy diet that your nutritionist or your dietologist or your doctor, if you're diabetic like me, can advise for you. For example, especially since the coronavirus pandemic, I talked with my doctor, and he advised me on avoiding food that causes inflammation in the body, because I'm a diabetic patient. And he told me, he explained to me that by eating food that causes inflammation in the body, you make your body more susceptible to having health issues in case you contact the coronavirus. People who are anxious about health-related issues might benefit from making a backup plan. Yes, a backup plan. Now it comes to my mind one very difficult time our family passed. It was on February of 2014, and my father had to undergo a heart surgery with a great risk. The doctors explained to us that there was a risk that he wouldn't survive the operation. Thank God he survived the operation and he's healthy and sound. And now he's even healthier at the age of 71 than he was at that time when he had to undergo the heart surgery. I remember the last night before his surgery, we were in his room at the hospital, my mother, my son, my daughter and me. And we went to see, we took him to the hospital. We stayed there while he was getting ready to sleep. We kissed him, we hugged him, and we went back in the house. And all of us, all the four of us, my mother, my children, and I, were really, really worried, very worried, because my father is a very important part of our lives. He's a very special person. And all of us depend on my father's presence in our lives, emotionally mostly. He's a very important, reliable source of love, of advice, of affection. He's, for all of us, not only my children, my mother and I, but my brother and his children and his wife as well, he's a very important person in our lives who makes us feel safe when he's around. So we were not ready in 2014 to lose my father, and we are not ready now, and I think that we will never be ready to lose our parents, that we have a great connection with them. Even if we don't have a great connection with our parents, we are not ready to lose them. Anyway, that night, the night prior to his heart surgery, we went back to my flat in Nicosia, and we were sitting around the table, and I told them, we should address the issue. What will we do in case tomorrow dad doesn't wake up from the surgery? I wished with all my heart for him to survive the surgery. I prayed hard for him to survive the surgery, and he did. But in order for us to be able to sleep that night and to be able to move on with this difficult and strenuous situation, we needed to make a backup plan. So I made a backup plan, and I said, in case my father does not survive the operation, at that time, my son was living with my parents in Paphos. Paphos is a small town in Cyprus, where I come from. I was living in the capital with my daughter in Nicosia. So I said to them, in case my father does not survive the operation, me and my daughter will move to Paphos and stay with you in the same house, so as to take care of everything that my father used to take, my father takes care of, in case we lose him. This backup plan, no matter how scary it was or how morbid it was to talk about such a backup plan, helped us sleep that night. Thank God we didn't need to use it. My suggestion is that people who have health anxiety issues and they are extremely stressed by the coronavirus pandemic to make such a backup plan. What will happen if I contact the virus and I'm sick? What happens if I contact the virus and I am asymptomatic and I need to restrain myself in quarantine? What happens if my child contacts the virus? What happens if any other person of my family contacts the virus? Making a backup plan will help us feel better. We make the backup plan, we put it in a drawer, and we don't talk about it. But we know that we have a backup plan, even for the worst case scenario. This is so helpful in a cognitive level. Another another vital tool in order to be better emotionally and psychologically during this time of pandemic is to stay connected with other people at the same time when practicing social distancing. I know, it's a paradox. How can I advise you to practice social distancing and at the same time stay connected with other people? Thank God, in 2020, that we have this pandemic, we have fine technology that can give us the opportunity, that gives us the opportunity to see each other through video calling. If we see the face of a person that we love, even in a video call, and we see their facial expressions, and we see their smile, and we hear their voice, this can have a very calming effect on us. So all of us who practice social distancing or who self-quarantine, everybody is in a different country, they have a different situation, please invest in staying connected with the people in your life, your family, your friends. Now it's time to talk with the people you haven't talked in ages. Now it's time to heat up older connections with friends and family. And if you are single, why not heat up older flames? Only if you are single, but so as not to make other issues. It's very important in these conversations with people that we try to stay connected with in our life We do not allow coronavirus to dominate every conversation. There are several other issues, thousands of other issues to talk about rather than coronavirus. Let's don't let the pandemic dominate every conversation, because the things we talk about, the more you talk about something, the more it affects your brain. And you should know that emotions are contagious. So if you tend to support to somebody who is pessimistic and they have negative emotions, you will be affected in a negative way. But if you turn for support, for emotional support and human connection, to somebody who is optimistic and has a very fun and outgoing way of seeing life, then you can also be lifted and elevated emotionally. At this time, we should also take care of our body, mind, and spirit, and be kind to ourselves. It's not a time to be harsh on ourselves, to think about our old mistakes, or to make and blame ourselves for things that are out of our control. Coronavirus is out of our control. It's not my fault. It's not your fault. It's not anybody's fault that is watching this video that coronavirus has came into our lives. The pandemic is not our fault. And we need to be kind with ourselves so as to help ourselves go through this difficult period. And last but not least, helping others can make us feel better. Let's be a calming influence in our environment. Let's help people in our environment feel better. Let's help people feel calmer. Let's be kind to others. Let's spread love, empathy, understanding, true human connection faster than the virus. I'm telling you this, and I truly believe it, and I strongly support it, that coronavirus pandemic will go one day. I don't know when, maybe in a year, I don't know. I was reading these days an interview by Dr. Fauci from the World Health Organization, and he stated in the interview that it's relatively safe for people to plan their weddings in 2022. This gives me an idea that maybe for a year or so, we will still have restrictions in our social life and we'll still have to take precautions and practice social distancing. But after that, we will be able to return back to normality. And I hope so. And I really do hope so. But if we help ourselves adapt in this new way of living, we can help ourselves to release stress, to lower stress levels, and to be happier in such difficult times. And I'm closing this video by saying again that if somebody has a diagnosis from a psychologist or a psychiatrist that has to do with stress, like generalized anxiety disorder or any kind of specific phobia or anxiety disorder, during these times, you should contact your doctor, have regular conversations with your doctor, and stick to your medication. And please, all of us, the rest of us, should avoid self-medicating, taking pills without prescription to deal with anxiety, or using alcohol to deal with anxiety, and several. I wish that this time in our lives, which is a stressful time, a difficult time, will be proven beneficial for us to be stronger to overcome any difficult situation. I send you my love. Bye everybody. If you liked my video, please share it with your friends and family, subscribe to my channel, and every Friday around noon, a new video is uploaded in English. Bye.